In this episode of Be Well Buzz Wellness Wednesdays, we talk about the new science of epigenetics, how our emotions impact our health, and how stress can cause cancer. Recently, headlines blew up with the news of Angelina Jolie's double mastectomy. While we won't judge Angelina's choice, it is at her right to do what she wants with her body. We are deeply disturbed by the potential consequences of media portraying it as a noble act of courage. We are also concerned that Angelina's stature will inspire others to move forward with this procedure without having all the options. With that in mind, we humbly present our point of view for consideration. Let's start with Bruce Lipton's work, who is a developmental biologist and a professor at the New Zealand College of Chiropractic. About 60 and a half years ago, a hypothesis emerged that genes control life. Lipton calls this a doctrine of predetermination, meaning that your DNA and your genes are set from birth, and so are you. Your genetic blueprint will determine what you look like, how you will develop, destined diseases, program strength and weaknesses, and who you will be. Nature beats nurture. At the time this was discovered, it seemed humans would be subject to the random expressions of our DNA, hanging on to a faint hope that a dangerous disease-causing gene would never come alive, praying that only the best ones would express in us and our children. Although it was never scientifically demonstrated, the notion of genetic control was passed down from the late 1950s to the next generation and accepted as a fundamental rule of life. Ironically, scientists themselves coined this genetic control theory as a central dogma. One day, Lipton got curious and checked out the definition of dogma. Here is what he found. Dogma is a belief based on religious persuasion and not scientific fact. But of a greater interest to Lipton, among many others, is the likelihood that the reverse is actually true. That is, DNA is not the boss of you. Rather than being a predestined blueprint, it's more like a map of options. Lipton says that you determine what manifests from your DNA based on your beliefs. What you believe gives rise to your behavior, choices, lifestyle, and emotions, and these tell your DNA what genes to activate. Let's look at the power of our emotions. There is a fresh buzz about cancer-causing genes ever since Angelina Jolie decided to undergo a double mastectomy. Breast cancer had plagued her family line for several generations, and she was carrying the gene. Hoping to decrease her chances of actualizing the disease, Jolie had both of her breasts removed. Perhaps Angelina did what she had to do, but researchers are questioning whether we ought to feel quite so helpless and victim to our own DNA. New scientific data is supporting the idea that we can choose to empower health or disease. These researchers say that power lies in our emotions. The somewhat infamous Dr. R.G. Hamer is credited with 30 years of research examining the connection between trauma and cancer. He claims that every case of cancer can be traced back to some unexpected and traumatic event. The shock and the resulting emotional stress activate what he calls an intentional program of nature. Cancer is created within and by the person's own system according to a mutated program. To heal physically, one must heal heart and mind, because he wrote, psyche, brain, and organ are three levels of the same organism, and the course of events in them is always coexistent. Lipton says that emotions trigger the expression either of wellness or sickness. Over 100 years ago, a physician named Eli Jones left the conventional medical practice, which he found to be more harmful than helpful, and practiced his own combination of Native American herbology, homeotherapy, and other healing methods. After 40 years experience studying and treating the disease, he claimed that it could cure cancer and authored the book Cancer, Its Causes, Symptoms, and Treatment. Jones is credited with stating explicitly that number one cause of cancer is stress. A couple of years ago, a geneticist at Yale University led a research team who concluded that daily emotional stress causes tumor growth. Recent breakthroughs have astounded researchers who have found that stress opens up pathways between mutated cells, enabling them to cooperate in creating the tumor. So no stress, no communication pathways. If you have stress, the potential cancer cells can talk. Scientists at the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center just released the results of their study this year, entitled Stress Triggers Signaling Pathways That Leads to Spread of Ovarian Cancer. In short, stress empowers disease. Bruce Lipton says there is a new biology that will take you from victim to master of your health. He explains that epigenetic controls is the emerging science revealing that humans can either be at the mercy of our genes or use the power of the mind to master them. Whereas the placebo effect causes healing through positive thinking, a lesser known nocebo effect manifests sickness or death through negative thoughts and beliefs. In some sense, this revelation is good news because it puts the ball back in our court. It removes the mystery and offers a clear solution. Avoid stress and pursue peace of mind and heart, as your life depends on it. You see, beliefs, stress, and emotions are intertwined. If we are consistently believing that we have been wronged, that somebody owes us, that we're not good enough to live in this world, that belief is going to create corresponding emotions. Depression weakens our immune system and disrupts circadian rhythms. Anger produces stress hormones. Resentment, bitterness, and unforgiveness will literally eat you up inside and empower stress in our body, which then empowers disease. Donnie Jens wrote, "Fear is a great obstacle of healing. When people have cancer, all of a sudden they are filled with fear." So how do we reverse this trend? Hammer believed that emotional healing is the key. Lipton says you must change your beliefs and nurse your emotional state to health. Lipton, Hammer, Jens, and many, many others agree that we've got to treat stress like a disease itself. Oppose both the beliefs and feelings that keep us from realizing love, joy, and peace, which are health-promoting emotions. Maybe it's something like, if you've experienced trauma, don't bury it, but make it your priority to get help. Consider it as urgent as treating a terminal illness. Or someone wronged you, forgive them. If you have resentment, let it go. Don't waste time holding grudges, which strangle your health. Toxic emotions don't harm your adversary. They harm the one hosting them. So don't let them control your health and your life.